We begin with major breaking news that US President Joe Biden has formally announced that he's withdrawing from the US presidential election. In a statement that was shared on his social media channels a little earlier from his COVID isolation, he said he believed it's in the best interest of his party. Our Washington correspondent Annalise Nielsen joins us live now from Washington, D.C. So, Annalise, this breaking news has been going for a little over an hour's time now. So, I mean, it was a few hours before that that he was digging his heels in. So what happened? What changed?
Well, look, the sense was that the campaign had to be fully in until they were out. And this momentum was building for some time. As much as we've been looking at the machinations of members of Congress joining calls to quit about protests, really, at the end of the day, once you've lost the donors, you've lost the race. And it became just completely untenable. Even with $250 million US dollars locked in the Biden-Harris campaign, they were losing more in prospective donations that they were relying on to keep that momentum up. So it just became something of a foregone conclusion, as much as this is just an extraordinary moment in history. We understand this is the latest that any candidate has pulled out of a US presidential campaign as the presidential candidate in history. So Joe Biden made this announcement somewhat discreetly by just posting it to social media channels as a letter. We can read that full letter for you now. It says, "My fellow Americans, over the past 3.5 years, we have made great progress as a nation. Today, America has the strongest economy in the world. We've made historic investments in rebuilding our nation, in lowering prescription drug costs for seniors, and in expanding affordable health care to a record number of Americans. We've provided critically needed care to 1 million veterans exposed to toxic substances, passed the first gun safety law in 30 years, appointed the first African-American woman to the Supreme Court, and passed the most significant climate legislation in the history of the world. America has never been better positioned to lead than we are today. I know none of this could have been done without you, the American people. Together, we overcame a once-in-a-century pandemic and the worst economic crisis since the Great Depression. We've protected and preserved our democracy, and we've revitalized and strengthened our alliances around the world. It has been the greatest honor of my life to serve as your president, and while it has been my intention to seek re-election, I believe it is in the best interests of my party and the country for me to stand down and to focus solely on fulfilling my duties as president for the remainder of my term. I will speak to the nation later this week in more detail about my decision. For now, let me express my deepest gratitude to all those who have worked so hard to see me re-elected. I want to thank Vice President Kamala Harris for being an extraordinary partner in all this work. And let me express my heartfelt appreciation for the American people, for the faith and trust you've placed in me. I believe that today what I always have, that there is nothing America can't do when we do it together. We just have to remember we are in the United States of America." Now, the first read of that, everyone said the same thing. No endorsement for Kamala Harris. And it only took a few moments for then the Biden account to then post that formal endorsement of Kamala Harris saying, "My fellow Democrats, I've decided not to accept the nomination and to focus all my energies on my duties as president for the remainder of my term. My very first decision as the party nominee in 2020 was to pick Kamala Harris as my vice president, and it's been the best decision I've made. Today, I want to offer my full support and endorsement for Kamala Harris to be the nominee of our party this year. Democrats, it's time to come together and beat Trump. Let's do this." Of course, it didn't take long for Donald Trump to respond himself. He's posted on Truth Social, "Crooked Joe Biden was not fit to run for president and is certainly not fit to serve and never was. He only attained the position of president by lies, fake news and not leaving his basement. All those around him, including his doctor and the media, knew that he wasn't capable of being president and he wasn't. And now look what he's done to our country with totally unchecked and unvetted many from prisons, mental institutions, and record numbers of terrorists. We will suffer greatly because of his presidency, but we will remedy the great damage he has done very quickly. Make America great again." Now, the walls were closing in on Joe Biden for quite some time since his disastrous appearance at the presidential debate just 24 days ago. What we've seen is a number of Democrats come out and say that he needs to pass the torch. We had Joe Manchin, former Democrat, now independent senator, but very influential, especially in the Senate, which tends to be more bipartisan. But he came out today and said he also thought Joe Biden needed to go.
"And I came to the decision with a heavy heart that I think it's time to pass the torch to a new generation. I believe that he has a chance, an opportunity, to finish the 5 months of his presidency with the way he has always, basically overseen his office, whether it be a senator or as president, wanting to be that uniter, bringing us together, being able to bring peace to the Middle East, being able to support Ukraine in their fight for freedom, and also being able to show the whole world have a transfer of power.